हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड। सो वेलकम बैक इन आवर न्यू लेक्चर वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अडैप्टिव थ्रेश होल्डिंग। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन दैट देर आर फ्यू थ्रेश होल्ड मैथड्स इन विच वी आर पासिंग थ्रेश होल्डिंग वैल्यू एज अ कॉन्स्टेंट। सो in all over the image this constant value we can't change while implementing. So to overcome this issue, this situation, we can adopt adaptive thresholding. Adaptive thresholding is a method which work in a smaller region of an image, means according to the neighbor pixels, the particular pixel is going to be changed. So let's start by implementing adaptive thresholding. Let's create a new folder with 14th class. New file name. Adaptive thresholding, OpenCV python.py. So as you all know, what we have to do first, import CV2, import numpy as np, then we have to read the image cv2.imread method, then data slash sudoku.png, and we have to read in a grayscale, so we have to pass 0. cv2.im show original image, then the source cv2.weightkey, cv2.destroy all windows. Let me run the code. So as you can see that this is our original image. So we have to apply adaptive thresholding to this image. So we have two thresholding method. One is adaptive thresh mean C, and another adaptive thresh Gaussian C. So adaptive thresh mean C converts particular pixels value according to their neighborhood and subtracting the constant C from it. And adaptive thresh Gaussian C value is find the weighted sum of neighbor values and subtract the constant C. So let's implement and see how it works. So adaptive threshold function we have to pass the source, then another variable is 255. 255 is the highest pixel in the image. cv2.type we have to pass. So type of the image is thresh binary. Then we have to pass cv2.adaptive adaptive trash meme. Then after we have to pass the type trash meme C, then save it to trash binary the type, and then after the neighbors pixel that we want to hit, so 2, and the constant value of C will be 2. So now let's see how it's impact our image. cv2.im show th2 comma th2. Let me run the code. So as you can see that our original image and our adaptive thresholding means C image. So let me load the thresh binary image also, so we can find the real difference between thresholding, that normal thresholding, and adaptive thresholding, source and binary thresholding. So 127 comma 255, then cv2 dot thresh binary. So let me show this image also, th1 comma th1. Dot. So as you can see that how thresh binary is working is converting all the pixels below 127 to 0 and the above one is 255, and you can see that the adaptive thresholding, it calculating the mean of nearby pixels and adapt their threshold according to that. Now let's see Gaussian adaptive thresholding. Adaptive thresholding Gaussian, see the name of that particular method, and in this we have to all the parameters, it was just we have to change the variable. Now let's see the outputs of Gaussian thresholding. So this is our binary, this is our adaptive thresholding mean, and this is our Gaussian thresholding. So as you can see that Gaussian thresholding working little bit much better than binary and adaptive thresholding. So that's it for today. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Let's meet in our next class with the new topic. Thank you, friends.